Coming up on Fresh Dew with Pastor Nkechi Ene.
Sometimes you can experience the hand of God in a supernatural and even spectacular event, but that still doesn't remove the truth that you have to go on a deliberate, intentional journey to know Him. Child of God, this is the call for you to know God, a call for you to get on a deliberate, intentional journey to know who God is.
Dancing with Your Spirit, a book by Pastor Nkechi Ene. Visit freshdew.tv or call 0700 Get Media to place your order today. Also available at bookshops nationwide.
Hello and welcome to Fresh Dew. I am Pastor Nkechi Ene and it's always my pleasure to welcome you to every single episode of Fresh Dew. Fresh Dew is a program designed just for you. It's designed to build you up and to give you fresh inspiration and direction for your life. Today we continue our message series, Discernment for the Last Days. And this is part 23 of that message series, Discernment for the Last Days. This message is being taken in three sections. The first section was recognizing a balanced gospel. And that was from part 1 to part 10. And then we took recognizing a false minister. That was from part 11 to 22, and yay, we finished that section. And we're starting the third section, which is recognizing a good shepherd. So today from part 23, we begin to look at recognizing a good shepherd. So let's delve straight into it. The first section under that is Jesus, the good, great shepherd. Jesus is the good and great shepherd. He's the role model for shepherds. He's the role model for pastors. He's the reference point. He's the one we need to look up to and figure out who he is, and then we can figure out who these pastors should be. And this Jesus has set under shepherds in the body of Christ. You know, maybe one day we'll do an in-depth teaching on the local church and understand the concept of the local church. And the local church is meant to be pastored by an under-shepherd, not by an executive board or committee, by the under-shepherd. But that under-shepherd has to be placed there by Jesus, the good, great shepherd. Look at what he says about himself in John 10. And I want to just read the whole section, verses 1 to 16, to give us some, you know, some context in but the actual verse we're interested in is verse 11. So let's start from verse 1, John 10. Most assuredly, I say to you, he who does not enter the sheepfold by the door, but climbs up some other way, the same is a thief and a robber. But he who enters by the door is the shepherd of the sheep. To him the doorkeeper opens, and the sheep hear his voice. And he calls his own sheep by name and leads them out. And when he brings out his own sheep, he goes before them. And the sheep follow him, for they know his voice. Yet they will by no means follow a stranger, but will flee from him, for they do not know the voice of strangers. Jesus used this illustration, but they did not understand the things which he spoke to them. Then Jesus said to them again, "Most assuredly I say to you, I am the door of the sheep. All whoever came before me are thieves and robbers, but the sheep did not hear them. I am the door. If anyone enters by me, glory be to God, he will be saved and he will go in and out and find pasture. The thief does not come except to steal and to kill and to destroy. I have come that they may have life and that they may have it more abundantly. This popular John 10:10, you see the context in which he's saying it. And right after that, John 10:11, look at what he says. I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd gives his life for the sheep. But a hireling, he who is not the shepherd, one who does not own the sheep, sees the wolf coming and leaves the sheep and flees. And the wolf catches the sheep and scatters them. The hireling flees because he's a hireling and does not care about the sheep. Again, in verse 14, he says, oh, glory be to God. I'm just so overwhelmed by God's word here. He says in verse 14, I am the good shepherd and I know my sheep and I'm known by my own. As the Father knows me, even so I know the Father, and I lay down my life for the sheep. Another sheep I have, which are not of this fold, them also I must bring, and they will hear my voice, and there will be one flock and one shepherd. That is the voice of the good shepherd. That is the voice of the one who is the role model, the one who is the reference point for us as ministers, as pastors. Look at Jeremiah 23. 1-4, woe to the shepherds who destroy and scatter the sheep of my pasture, says the Lord. Therefore, thus says the Lord God of Israel, against the shepherds who feed my people, you have scattered my flock, driven them away, and not attended to them. Behold, I will attend to you for the evil of your doings, says the Lord. But I will gather the remnant of my flock out of all countries where I have driven them, and bring them back to their folds, and they will be fruitful and increase. Look at verse 4. That's our verse of interest. I will set up shepherds over them who will feed them, and they shall fear no more, nor be dismayed, nor shall they be lacking, says the Lord. Glory be to God. So to identify the under-shepherds, remember this is recognizing a good shepherd or a good under-shepherd. So to identify the under-shepherds or the pastors, there's so many pastors everywhere, we want to find those who Jesus, the great shepherd, has set up, like he said. He would set up shepherds over them. You know, to identify them, we need to know Jesus and the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, or we will be scattered. If we don't know Jesus, who is the reference point, who is the role model, who is the mold from which every stamp is made, every pastor comes out of, then you can't really identify an under-shepherd. So you need to, first of all, know and identify the good shepherd, who is the one who sets up under shepherds after his likeness or after his own kind. Amen. Look at what he says about himself in John 5:18. Therefore, the Jews sought all the more to kill him. Follow me now. Because he not only broke the Sabbath, but also said that God was his Father, making himself equal. Remember that, with God. Then Jesus answered and said to them, most assuredly, I say to you, the Son can do nothing of himself, but what he sees the Father do. For whatever he does, the Son also does in like manner. Whatever he does, the Son also does in like manner. And they said he made himself equal with God. Watch this now. Same John 10, look at verse 30. I and my Father are one. So what are we bringing out of this? You know, there is God, there is Jesus, who is the Son. God is the Father in the position. And Jesus is saying, everything I see the Father do is what I do. I do it in like manner with the Father. The Father and I are one. In other words, we can say that if we want to know the nature of Jesus, we need to look at the nature of God. They have exactly they are one and the same person. So the nature of God is the nature of Jesus. So when we begin to study the nature of God, we can figure out the nature of Jesus. Now, why is that important and relevant to us in this message series? Because we've just said that Jesus is the good shepherd. He's a role model. He's the reference point. We want to recognize good under shepherds. In these last days, there are all kinds of pastors, all kinds of people who call themselves shepherds. We want to identify the ones that Jesus set up. Well, to do that, we need to know Jesus. And to know Jesus, we need to know God, because God and Jesus have the same nature. So if we know the nature of God, we know the nature of Jesus, and therefore we can use that as a reference point to begin to look for those traits in a good shepherd. And if we find those traits in a good under shepherd, we say, this under shepherd, just like Jesus said, I do what I do in like manner with my Father. A good pastor will be telling you, what I do in like manner with Jesus, the good shepherd, my boss, the one who I'm cut out of his mold. Glory be to God. There's an expression I always use, and I say it often. It's not a luxury to hear from God. You can say in this context, it's not a luxury to hear from Jesus. If you're an under shepherd, you need to be cut out of the mold of Jesus. You need to hear from him, know his nature, know the nature of God. And you, a child of God who wants to recognize and identify a good under shepherd, a good pastor, you need to know the nature of God. And you need to know him and know the nature of Jesus. That way you have a reference point. And when you match the under shepherd or match the pastor, yeah, it's a human being. Yes, sometimes he'll make mistakes. But you match the essence of who that pastor is. You can tell if Jesus is the one. With this nature I have discovered, is this person really set up by the Lord Jesus Christ? Or is he or she a false minister? Glory be to God. So a revelation of the nature of God is thus a revelation of the great shepherd. This will help us identify who a good under shepherd is, as we should be able to see the Jesus we see and know in them. I'll still make that statement again. A revelation of the nature of God is thus a revelation of the great shepherd, Jesus. This will help us identify who a good under shepherd is, as we should be able to see the Jesus we see and know in them. So the next section, first thing we've looked at now, is Jesus the good great shepherd. The next one, B, you can call it, is revelations of the nature of God and thus the nature of Jesus Christ. Let's begin to look at revelations of the nature of God. We can see why now we're doing this before we now get into, you know, tips, characteristics of a good under shepherd. But let's look at the revelation of the nature of God, which is thus the revelation of the nature of Jesus Christ. Under that, first thing we're going to look at now is a call to know God. A call to know God. It's amazing, friends, how many people know of God, know about God, but don't know God. It's amazing how many people know of God, know about God, but don't know God. Bring it closer. It's amazing how many people know of Jesus, know about Jesus, can speak Christianese, but they don't know Jesus. What's more tragic is when such people in this category are found in the body of Christ. When you're born again Christians who know of God, who know about God, who speak Christianese, but they don't know Jesus. They don't have a personal relationship with Jesus. You know, something that my pastor Charles always used to say was he would ask people this direct question, who is Christ to you? Who is Christ to you? Child of God, I put that question across to you. Who is Christ to you? Don't be quick, oh, he's my savior, he's my Lord, he's my everything. Is he really your everything? Do you know him? Can you, off the cuff, list certain characteristics about him? You know, if you're married to someone, the person might do something, or you hear the person did something. You say, no, my husband can't do that. I know my husband. I don't even care if you say you caught him red-handed. You've got to give me the evidence. I don't believe that my husband would ever do that kind of thing, because I know him. No, my wife can't have said that. I really don't care what you remember, what you overheard. I know my wife. I'd rather be caught as a fool who didn't really know the person they were living with all these years than quickly believe something that doesn't line up with what I know about this person. But you have believers who don't know Jesus. They know of him. They know about him. They've heard about him. They speak the language, but they don't know him. They don't know him. Glory be to God. God has been a victim of identity theft. People have believed in other gods, and they call them God. You know, you have people who idolize all kinds of things and they call them God, but that ought not to be so. Look at Psalm 46 and verse 10. Be still and know that I am God. I will be exalted among the nations. I will be exalted in the earth. God wants you to know him. God wants you to be still and know him. And sometimes, you know, when we're overwhelmed by situations and overwhelmed by circumstances, there's storms, there's trouble, there's wind, there's rain. You don't have time to actually know God. God says to you, child of God, and I send this word out to you watching, be still and know that he's God. There's a time to get to know him. This is a call for you to know God, a call for you to know his nature, a call for you to know who he truly is. Because when you get that, you get the nature of God, of Jesus, and you get the nature of the great shepherd. So God wants us to know him. He doesn't want us to know of him, about him, or call others him. He wants us to know him. Glory be to God. Now, let me say this. Many times, it's in the place of adversity and temptation that how much you know God comes out. You know, when things are not going the way you expect them to be, or something suddenly happens unexpectedly, what do you then know about God? It's in that place of adversity or that place of temptation that you know who God is. When you have revelation of who God is, no matter the storms that hit your way, you'll stand as an ambassador of God. You'll stand as an ambassador of his word. Others will be fretting for you. Others will be getting worried for you. But you know him. You know the nature of God. Some of the things we're going to learn in the weeks to come. You'll find out more about him. And you say, no, this is the God I know. How well you know God is not tested when there is peace everywhere. How well you know God is tested when there are no storms. How well you know God is tested when adversity and temptation suddenly comes upon you. Child of God, in these last days, you need to know the nature of God. You need to be still. Glory be to God. You need to be still. God's presence is so mighty in this place. You need to be still and know that he is God. All those lies, all those lying symptoms, all those lying circumstances, they want to take your eyes off who God is. If they take your eyes off who God is, they'll take your eyes off who Jesus is. If they take your eyes off who the great and good shepherd is, they'll take your eyes off anybody who is a real shepherd, and you fall into the hands of false ministers. Many times it's adversity and temptation that takes people into the hands of false ministers. But when you know who God is, then you can overcome every adversity and every situation. Let me read you this story, which we all know, story of the woman with the issue of blood. And we'll learn from there that, you know, you can actually receive certain things from God and still not know him. Mark 5:25. Now a certain woman had a flow of blood for 12 years and had suffered many things from many physicians. She had spent all that she had and was no better, but rather grew worse. When she heard about Jesus, she came behind him in the crowd and touched his garment, for she said, "If only I may touch his clothes, I shall be made well." Immediately the fountain of her blood was dried up, and she felt in her body that she was healed of the affliction. And Jesus, immediately knowing in himself that power had gone out of him, turned around in the crowd and said, "Who touched my clothes?" But his disciples said to him, "You see the multitude thronging you, and you say, 'Who touched me?'" And he looked around to see her who had done this thing. But the woman, fearing and trembling, knowing what had happened to her, came and fell down before him and told him the whole truth. And he said to her, "Daughter, your faith has made you well. Go in peace and be healed of this affliction, of your affliction." Something interesting that I see here, we talk a lot about the woman with the issue of blood having heard about Jesus. She had heard about Jesus, but she didn't know him. If she knew him, she wouldn't have been afraid. If she knew him, she wouldn't have tried to run away with her healing. If she knew him, she wouldn't have been trembling as she came to respond to his call. "What happened? Something happened to me. I felt virtue leave me." That means you can actually receive a miracle from God and still not know him. That means you can answer an altar call, which is an invitation to know him, and still not know him. That means you can be a born-again Christian for 20 years and not know him. You can be healed of cancer and still not know him. Another situation could come your way, and you begin to doubt God, because maybe your healing from cancer came through the gifts of the Spirit, or came through the faith, you know, coupled with your faith of someone else, or some miraculous supernatural intervention. That doesn't mean you have known him. The statement I want to say here, knowing him is a deliberate journey and not an event, regardless of how supernatural and even spectacular that event was. I want to say it again. Knowing him is a deliberate journey and not an event, regardless of how supernatural and even spectacular that event was. So some of us have had really amazing events, and sometimes those events are meant to be triggers. They're meant to be triggers into your discovering more about God. A God who would heal me like this, I want to know more about him. I love it when I see in ministries where somebody gets healed in the ministry and it stirs up a fire within them. And suddenly they're not content anymore just being a bench warmer. They begin to get involved. And some of them end up even having a call of God into the ministry that was lying there dormant all along. So the healing was a trigger. Or the miracle that happened to them was a trigger. Or the deliverance from a ghastly accident was a trigger. So sometimes you can experience the hand of God in a supernatural and even spectacular event, but that still doesn't remove the truth that you have to go on a deliberate, intentional journey to know him. Child of God, this is the call for you to know God, a call for you to get on a deliberate, intentional journey to know who God is. It's critical in these last days that you know who God is, because when you know who God is, you will know who Jesus is. When you know who Jesus is and know that he's the Great Shepherd, you will identify and begin the journey of recognizing a good under-shepherd, and you will not find yourself in the hands of false ministers. We'll continue this next episode and begin to look at how Paul himself began to call out for a need for him, who already had experienced Jesus, even supernaturally, to know him even more. And if Paul can make that call, then who are you, child of God, not to decide to get on that journey to know God? Father, thank you. Thank you for calling us out to know you. Thank you because you're open and transparent. You've taken away all the mystery with your church, and you want us to know you and know who you are. Thank you because your people are even answering that call right now. Even your grace and your anointing is calling them out and calling them out onto a deliberate, intentional journey to know you, a God who loves them and a God who's given his best for them, a God who's set up under shepherds to take care of them even in these last days. Thank you, Lord. We give you the praise. Oh, we give you all the glory. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Oh, thank you, Lord. Thank you, for I sense that there are those who've been battered and bruised by shepherds. Your word to them today is healing has come. Healing has come. You will discover that they are good shepherds. You'll discover that there's restoration for you in God. Where you have found yourself a victim of false ministers, a victim of bad shepherds, God is here to reassure you, child of God, that there are ministers set up by Jesus himself, and he will lead you and guide you in a place of restoration into such shepherds, into the hands of such shepherds, in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Father.
You have so many questions about your life and life in general. Why? When? How? What? Who? And the list goes on. Sister, Jesus is the answer to every question, and he loves you just the way you are. He loves you too much to leave you this way. He is knocking on the door of your heart. Will you make a decision for a change today? To surrender your life to Jesus Christ, the Son of a living God. If you want to do that, say this prayer out loud, meaning it from the depth of your heart, according to Romans 10:8-13, and you will be saved. Lord Jesus, I come to you today. I believe you are the Son of God, and that you died for me and rose again just to save me. Come into my heart and make me brand new as you have promised. I will live for you all the days of my life. In your name I pray, amen. Amen and amen. Congratulations on taking the most important decision of your life. You are now born again and a brand new person. It has all happened on the inside of you. We can help you grow in your new faith so that what has just happened on the inside will surely be reflected in your everyday life. Please call us at 0700 Fresh Dew or email us at saved@freshdew.tv, and we will be there for you.
Thank you for watching Fresh Dew today with Pastor Nkechi Ene. We trust you were blessed by today's episode. For further information on Fresh Dew, please call us on 0700 Fresh Dew which is 0700-3737-4339. If you're calling from outside Nigeria, the number will be +234-700-3737-4339. Our phones are open from 9 a.m. to 11 p.m. GMT plus one. You can also send us an email to info@freshdew.tv and we'll be glad to serve you. We also invite you to like, follow, and interact with us on our Twitter and Facebook pages at Freshdew TV and also on Pastor Nkechi's Facebook pages at Pastor Ketch. For more information on how you can partner with Freshdew and receive Pastor Nkechi's monthly letters and weekly MP3 gifts, please visit our website, www.freshdew.tv. Once again, thanks for being with us today, and we look forward to seeing you next time on Freshdew to receive fresh inspiration and direction for your life.
Romans 10:17 says, "So then, faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of God." You can order today's message and other past messages on our website store, freshdew.tv. It is available on MP3 and CD, and also on MP4 and DVD, just as seen on TV. Fresh Dew, giving you fresh inspiration and direction for your life.